Hello and welcome to my world. I'm of course Fred Kasdan. As you know, 7 nights a week I stream live over on Twitch playing a variety of video games. The link to my Twitch channel can be found in the description below. Now this week I played plenty of games on both PC and Xbox One. However, one game was definitely a part of this year's gaming tour. It's called Runaway, a Road Adventure. It came out in 2001. It's a point-and-click graphic adventure game. Very much in a similar style to, say, Indiana Jones and the Fate of Atlantis, Day of the Tentacle, the Telltale's games such as, well, the Sam & Max series and Strong Bad game for attractive people and similar to stuff like that. You play as a singular protagonist, in this case Brian Bosco, and where life seems to be going a certain way for him. In this case, he's college bound, he's going to drive cross country to the university he got accepted into, and everything is hunky-dory, except as he's about to leave New York, he ends up literally running over the femme fatale that he ends up falling for and helping for the majority of the game, a girl named Gina, who was escaping from a nightclub after witnessing the murder of her quote-unquote father. Yeah, there's a plot twist involving that. This game, the adventure involves having to stay ahead of the mafia, escaping from the mafia, involves drag queens, crucifix, the Hopi Indians, all sorts of different things. It's a game where the story is definitely carrying it. The story is very good, in my opinion, and it's definitely done in the style of a road trip adventure. You start at one point, end up at another point, and everything works out perfectly for our heroes at the end of the day. Now, as I mentioned, this game is a point-and-click graphic adventure, which means there are plenty of puzzles. And this is where the game definitely has its biggest flaw. Many point-and-click adventure games, where you have to figure out puzzles, use of items, things of that nature, they're straightforward in what they want you to do, but you're not limited in as to when you can start putting the pieces together. When you see that you have certain items that look like they can go together and they actually do go together, in almost any other point-and-click adventure game, you can put those items together at any point in time and have them ready to go for the appropriate time. In Runaway, you may have the tools that you come across, but you can't use them until the game is ready for you to use them, and meaning you can't put Brian's amber into a stone rock you found, because it looks like it's like the little this little thing here looks like it'll fit perfectly in there. You can't do that until it's the appropriate time when the proper puzzle is activated for you to solve, and it's game is a bit baddie that way. Matter of fact, it forced me to end up looking for an online guide, thank goodness for GameFAQs, because of how anally precise everything is laid out. I mean, I get it. This game is designed to be like a road trip film. It's in many respects, it's very artistic in that way. But as a point-and-click adventure game with those types of puzzles, it was a bit maddening. But still, very good game. All in all, despite my issues with the puzzle mechanics, the story more than makes up for it. Like, as does the characters themselves. Brian himself can be a bit grating because the story is being told to you from his perspective. As a matter of fact, when you load up the game, you basically are greeted with Brian right off the bat, that everything that is taking place within the game has already happened, and he's just relaying you the events. And maybe that's kind of how the puzzle thing is laid out. It's because it's supposed to present it from his point of view and presenting the events as how he did them. So you had to do it everything the way he did it. It had to do it the exact same way he did. But his personality can be a little bit grating, but Morton makes up with it with the number of times he breaks the fourth wall. Particularly if you try to use a toilet, he'll literally turn around and go to the look at the screen at the player and says, "I'm not comfortable using it in public." So it is what it is there. Gina, our lead female protagonist, well, in terms of design, I don't think you can get away with a character like her today without her being more actively involved and having a bigger role in the story, other than being the reason for why the story is taking place. She's definitely from that late 90s, early 2000s period where certainly the sex appeal is there. Without question, it's there. I mean, her lips, her chest, and everything else about how she is designed is definitely presented up front for the player. So plenty of jokes made at the expense of Gina in terms of how the camera angles of it showed her off, but is what it is there. These days she would probably be the main character. If this game was remade for today, Gina would definitely have her own entire section of puzzles and things to do. Instead of a notorious section where she is crawling out of a mine she fell into, and you get a long drawn out shot of seeing her from crawling from behind and then her turning around on the back and then pushing herself along that with her, again, an ample chest being on damn near full display. A lot of the secondary characters certainly have their charm too. Even the primary antagonists that you end up interacting with the most, Gustav, and I forget the other guy's name, they certainly have their little charm. A lot of the designs of characters certainly stand out. Munchkin Bob, who is probably the literal definition of full-grown midget, basically has a fully developed upper body and has two very, very little legs. Because his hands and everything are literally almost dragging against the ground, certainly was memorable. It's like, this dude has no legs. He's half a person. What else stood up? Mama Dorita as a, almost like a Mexican voodoo priestess, coordinating a sound, certainly was unique, as was Oscar, her big old bodyguard, who ended up becoming the sheriff of the little ghost town of Douglasville. There is, I have to look it up, because I could have sworn that one character in it, which is a random Hopi Indian chief that you end up running across to late game, sounds like John St. John. Is like, as soon as I heard his voice, they're like, Chief Duke Nukem? So, but it stands out to me. Graphically, as you can tell, the game definitely looks very good for its age. It came out in 2001, so it's 19 years old at the time of this recording. However, in terms of streaming it on Twitch, you can't tell because I've actually expanded the clip thing is to where it's filling out a little bit more, but it will fill a display screen of 16 by 9, as most modern monitors are, OBS will not capture it via display capture. You have to use either window or game capture, and it forces it into a standard 4x3 window because the game came from that era. Now, I wouldn't mind seeing a remastered version of this game where it fills out the entire screen, particularly as a Twitch streamer. But it's not a make or break deal. Musically, there's a lot of musical cues for when you actually have success and stuff, but the music is not too memorable. The opening and closing theme is it's standard Euro pop from the mid late 90s, something that you'll probably hear in a nightclub alongside, say, Ace of Base, for lack of another more memorable Euro pop style band that I could think of at the point at this point in time. But musically, the score is nothing too memorable. Now, this game does have two sequels, Runaway 2, The Dream of the Turtle, and Runaway, A Twist of Fate, that came out in 2006 and 2009. I do have both games, and I intend at some point to stream them both. And eventually, maybe I'll figure out, we'll do follow-up reviews to see how the series evolved when I get around to doing those games at some point down the line. With that said, if you played Runaway Road Adventure or you watched the archive of my streams from earlier this week here on YouTube, leave your thoughts on the game in the comments section below. Till next time, my friends, and you are my friends, tighten your friendship bracelets, watch your hang down, and we'll see you later. Bye.